been a while since I've done a Cowling Chronicle. Many things have happened with the plane, and there's still a question as to whether I will be able to hold on to the plane. But I've been finishing it because people have said that if I did decide to sell, it would sell better as a completed airplane as opposed to an unfinished project. I'll give you a little update on the Cowling here and what we've been working on. As you can see, I've done the spinner, and I've since done all of the baffling on it. And the hardest part, really, of that is, number one, staying awake through the mundane task of putting baffling on, trimming, taking it off, number one, and number two, trying to work up the ability to laugh every time somebody talks about baffling being, you know, baffling. That one gets me every time. I have a vertical updraft engine here from Matatuck, which means that the airbox is fit under the fuel servo. And so you have to make that. That comes in a kit. I've done a couple of things. I've reinforced the bottom so that the fiberglass doesn't pull out. I went ahead and put in this emergency air door and stuff, although I don't know if I'll ever use it. And then I pro-sealed all around the bottom of it to give it even more strength. There's an 063 piece in there to help strengthen things. And because the throttle is over there, I had to work in a little recess, there. The Cowling has come out pretty good, as I've started to figure it out over the last year or so of doing this sort of thing. I still have some question as to how long a cut this thing has to be, because once you put on these baffle channels in the front, it's a major pain in the neck getting this thing on and off, so I'm still not sure how that's going to work. But anyway, you can see I've done all of the mating and the installation of hinges and stuff. Once I had, like everything else in constructing this plane, an idea of what I needed to do and what I was shooting for, it became, a lot easier. By the way, I'm in a new hangar, by the way. Isn't that nice? Nice lighting and everything. The top is here, and I've been working on the cosmetic aspect of this. I did cut out the oil cooler door here and installed the hinge and that sort of thing. I've put on this super prime stuff, trying to fill the pinholes. And what I did was I went with the Vans method, which was to mix up some epoxy, cut it with some acetone, and spread it on. That worked okay, I guess. It still had a lot of pinholes. And then I would fill that in with, what's the name of that stuff? Superfill, I think it is. And this is this product. It's a filler primer. And you really can't tell, of course, here whether there's any pinholes or not. I'm still not sure there are or not. But I've got to do a final sanding on that. And then if it came out okay, I think I will use Marhide as a final prime on that. The problem with the filler primer is it's $60 a quart. And like everything else, I've slopped it on pretty heavily. I rolled it on in my case. And so it's coming along, I'd have to say. Also, on this Cowling deal, you have these ramps you have to put on here to make a nice smooth entry into the innards of the baffling. And then you have to smooth it out and do all that sort of stuff. None of this is particularly hard, as it turns out. It's just time consuming, and you're always faced with that idea that if you get it wrong, you're going to be buying a new cowling. So I'm working on this plug. There has to be a plug here, not a plug, but a tube that goes from the snout right up to the filtered air box. So I'm working on that now, which involves doing some sanding around the snout and then putting this block on here and then kind of putting some sort of adhesive to hold it in place before you cut it out. And basically, we're going to make a little mold here and then lay up some fiberglass, and that's going to create this tube that will go nicely into the filtered air box. One of the first steps was to measure with the cowling on, the bottom cowling on, the distance between the front of the scoop back to the front of the air box, and in my case it was 2 and about 5/8, 2 1/2 to 5/8. Now the block that they send you is not 2 5/8 thick, so we're going to have to kind of see how that goes. And so all I'm going to do now is take a regular hole saw and just drill a hole in here to get started, and then we're just going to shape the foam out to equal this cutout here, the ramp or the snout, I guess it would be called, and eventually shape it, the back side of it, to equal the front of the air box. So we're going to make a nice transition from the snout into the air box, or at least that's our goal. And then we're just going to take a hacksaw blade and shape it. Before you do this, you want to make absolutely sure you take your filter out of there, which I wish I'd done before I started drilling around the bushing, because I've got a lot of cleaning to do in there. But this foam shreds everywhere, and of course there's tons of dust and stuff, so you want to make sure that doesn't get into your system. So really the only thing we want to do here is use this thing here. So we're going to take this off, take out the filter, and block off the opening and put the casing back on. And then what I'm going to do here is take a hacksaw blade and start cutting or shaping, keeping it flush with the snout, and lining it up with the the filtered air box, so that you're getting a nice transition. And of course the foam is exceedingly easy to work with. Doesn't take long at all. And you can really see why you want to take your filter out, because it's really quite a mess. What we're trying to do here is keep this, we don't want to have this hole get any smaller than it is with the snout, so this has got to be up front here level, and then it has to work its way up to make a nice ramp. Well, you could probably see in there. Now, because the thickness of the block didn't extend all the way to the filtered air box, I'm not exactly sure what that's going to mean when I go to lay in some fiberglass. So I couldn't show you while I'm doing it because fiberglassing is too messy, but I put three layers, maybe I went a fourth, I can't recall, around the snout. Now, the instructions say put a balloon in there to hold that, but here's the problem. When you fill up a balloon, it wants to go out the other side, so it pulls the whole thing down. Or if you don't get it exactly in the middle, it pulls the whole thing back. So I kind of waited until the fiberglass started to set up before I made the final shaping of it. I loaded it up with a lot of epoxy, and I laid it up there and formed it to the block as best I could, and then you know, I can sand it and such later, I guess, when I'm done, to bring it down into a better shape if it doesn't come down that way. I'm pretty sure it'll hold this way, and of course I have a lot of sanding and shaping to do, and then when I'm done with this layer here, I'll put some epoxy in, then put some peel ply in. I did try to put some peel ply in there and it didn't work out that well. So This was actually my second attempt. The first layup I just pulled out because it was going pretty badly. I love the smell of burning epoxy in the morning. And then we just fill in the weave a little bit all around so that we can sand that afterwards and make a nice transition. Now, I then sanded down after that slurry was finished. I then sanded it all down. Still had some rough spots, and so I mixed up some straight epoxy and slapped it on there, and then put this peel ply on. And I like to put a little epoxy on top of the peel ply too. And then hopefully tomorrow when I pull that off, that'll be a fairly uniform. I'll give it a final sand, and I think we'll be on our way. Nice. Okay, so let that cure a little bit more, and then we're going to sand.
Okay, so I've sanded it down. There's a couple of small holes that I want to fill, probably with some super fill or something. And now I'm chipping out the foam, but more importantly, the super fill I used to hold that foam in place. One tip is don't use too much of that. I use too much of that. It's pretty strong stuff. I only needed a couple of small globs.
So I've chipped away everything, kind of sanded it, cleaned it, and vacuumed it. And now I'm just planning, just putting a little acetone, rubbing a little acetone, because I want to put just one layer we'll do of cloth around the fillet area here for a little extra strength.
I've got four pieces of cloth here.
And just nicely tuck it around. Our last task is putting baffle material now around the box, so that when it meets with the tunnel, everything looks pretty good and everything is sealed up reasonably tight. Now this needs to go outside of the air box by an inch. It overlaps on the sides on the top. There's two pieces. So we simply measure an inch and move her out on one side. And finally, we just put the cowling back on. Now you have to put a few slits, or I think they call them notches, and that just makes it easier for me, notches on the baffle material, to put a screwdriver in there and kind of pry the baffle around the incoming air box as I'm installing it. It's a real bear to install, especially if you don't take out the baffle material from the nose inlets up here. Stick to it and you can get it installed. It's not the hardest part in the world. It is a little difficult with the instructions. I don't think they're particularly great. Another view of what's going on inside here. But I think it came out pretty good. And I hope it helps you get started on it. Good to be with you. See you again.